Hi, I'm Vitz. You know, a lot of people dismiss the hidden camera prank format. They think that it's childish at worst and pointless at best. I would like to prove you all that it's a valid form of entertainment and that with the right elements, it can change the world. Yes, I'm being serious. And this video from YouTuber Kai Senat is going to help me. I'm not saying that this is a good example. On the contrary, it's getting a reputation as the worst prank video of 2021. Which means I can use it for comparisons on how this kind of video should be. I haven't seen it yet, so I don't know what made people dislike it. Maybe the prank didn't go well, or maybe it was a bad idea from the start. All I know is that this channel has almost 1.5 million subscribers. And in order to have this kind of following, this Kai fellow must be likable and charming and funny, so... yep, I'd like to meet him.
The Suburban outside! You thought I wasn't gonna drive me, you know what I'm saying? I look like a rich. I look like a rich. Back then they did want me. Now look, they all on me. Back then they did want me.
Well, when I woke up this morning, I didn't think I would meet a cross between Chris Rock and Dr. Nostrix from Foot Fight, but here we are.
Wait, what happened though?
Bro, what are you doing?
Are you not allowed to play with tips?
Okay, hee ha ha, it's funny, man. I need you to put it back.
No, I'm not trying to be funny. I'm so serious right now.
Yeah. Why are you trying to?
He's trying to play a joke.
Yeah.
What?
When I talked about changing the world, I was referring to satirical pranksters like Sacha Baron Cohen. They don't fool around for the sake of it. They design the scenarios in a way that will expose something dark about society. In fact, the hidden camera format isn't just used for comedy. The show What Would You Do does that from time to time, but for the most part, it stages dramatic situations. It proves that even something as serious as a social experiment can be entertaining. And hey, I know that not everyone has those goals. Some content creators just want to make people laugh, and that's fine. But even then, it has to feel like effort was put into planning the prank. It can't just be, I came up with an idea, let's go do it. Kai, it's clear that you didn't think things through. The character that you're playing thinks that the purpose of a tip jar is that customers can grab the money and use it to pay it. In order to believe that, he would have to be someone who has been isolated from society or, well, an idiot. I mean, even if a place like a restaurant or a coffee shop are okay with customers getting free stuff, what's the point in handing them money so they can give it back? Another possibility would have been for you to pretend like you're from another country where tip jars are used this way. It's a silly idea because this can't happen anywhere on the planet. But if the employers had believed it, it would have provided commentary on how ignorant people can be when it comes to foreigners. But no, you're executing the prank while being yourself. That's why it's not working. You're not fooling these people. The way you talk, the way you act, the way you dress, there's no way an everyday person like you doesn't know what a tip jar is. So the employees can immediately tell that you're fucking with them. And no, you didn't need a higher budget to transform yourself. You didn't need prosthetics or any of that. Only new clothes and a different voice or accent.
You know, it would've been funny if you could say like, can somebody help me out? Or
yeah, if you needed us to help you out, we can help you out, but you just can't grab the tip jar and take money out of it.
Oh. The prank victims are giving the prankster advice. That is priceless.
Yeah, I'm recording right there. I'm just joking with y'all. No, no, it's just a joke.
That's not cool, though.
No, 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 I'm tipping y'all, though.
That's not even cool. You recording us like that? Why would you want to do that to us?
No, 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 it was a joke. It was a joke. I didn't mean no harm.
We don't need the money.
Okay, I know it was a joke. It's fine.
Damn.
We just, yeah.
Hey, now I feel bad. Here, take another one.
We'll take it.
Thank you. All right. Thank you. Kai, what's the matter? Isn't this what you wanted? This is the kind of prank designed to mess with people's heads, and those employees were annoyed and confused. So how else could they have reacted?
Can you believe that? I tipped them $40.
Tipped who $40?
The register people, and they just said they don't want it, like they don't care and stuff.
What? Hey, Did you forget that everything is being recorded? We saw those employees accepting your tip. Okay, it was after you insisted, but that's not the point. You're lying by omission, which is still lying. And why did you approach a random person to say all this? Do you want that lady's sympathy? Do you want her to agree with you in order to validate your point of view? Is this some kind of victim complex?
It was a joke. Sometimes you gotta laugh, it's a joke. I understand I'm touching their money. But I gave them $40 back, you feel what I'm saying? I'm not trying to be a menace, you feel what I'm saying? Like,
oh, so you did want them to be confused and annoyed until the reveal, and that's where you wanted them to laugh with you. Got it. Listen, there are people who don't like to be pranked, and there are people who do like it unless they're having a bad day. Being a prankster means that you'll make enemies along the way. Earlier, I mentioned Sacha Baron Cohen. You know how many times he's been sued? You need to accept it. If you can't live with the fact that people will stay mad at you, then maybe you should consider doing something else?
Wait, I can't pay for it though?
What you saying, bro?
With the tip jar.
No, bruh, this is tips,
bruh.
This not your money, it ain't come out your pocket.
I'm just playing with y'all. I'ma go ahead and tip y'all, my fault. I'm just playing with y'all.
Bruh, we don't do that, bruh. I don't even
not, know. I was just playing with y'all.
It's up to her if she wanna say, bruh.
You feel what I'm saying? Huh? No, I don't want, nah, I just came in for jokes. I ain't even try to make anything serious.
Guy. Pranksters who have their own TV show or a highly profitable YouTube channel usually tell the filming crew to show up at the end of the prank. Whenever you tell your victims the truth, all you can do is point your finger at your friend. I don't know what he's using to record all of this, but it's clearly not a big and expensive camera, and there's no boom mic either. So, when you tell them that it's a performance meant to be shown to the masses, it's normal for them to be hesitant. You're not giving them concrete evidence. They think that they're busting you doing something wrong. So to say, just kidding, it's like an excuse to avoid punishment.
You don't want my money?
No.
Damn, I'm thinking.
Even though some of them believed you and are annoyed by it, others think that you were being serious. So of course they're not going to accept your money. As far as they're concerned, you stole it from somewhere else.
Can I put some money in the tip jar at least?
Go ahead.
I'll put some for you. There you go. I ain't mean no harm, bro. The nigga wanna fight me over getting tipped $20. I understand it's their money and I'm playing around and I grab it and stuff, but I'm tipping them.
Huh? Excuse me? What kind of archaic privilege mentality is this? These peasants need to accept my charity because they're not going to receive it from anyone else. They need to accept me as their savior.
Telling me if I was to tip that nigga $1,000, he don't want my money.
Oh, there's more.
I tipped him 20. Nobody go tip him 20. I tipped Starbucks 40. They were still mad. I tipped them 20. They're still mad.
What is this? People are upset at me? I flaunt my bills in front of them to make them smile and it doesn't work? Why? Money is supposed to fix everything.
That'd be all.
Yeah, that'd be all.
Okay, so this is Kai's third and final attempt. Will he succeed?
Why?
Because we don't get paid for another 2 weeks, that's our tips.
All right, bro. All right. I'm gonna get some money for my thing. I'll be right back. The thing I just did was a whole joke, you know what I'm saying? I didn't wanna, you know what I'm saying, cause any problems and stuff. So I see y'all, 2 weeks is crazy to me. And hey, I'm gonna tip you, I'm gonna go ahead and tip you $100, bro. If you could, you feel what I'm saying? I was just joking around with the tip jar and shit, so I wanna go ahead and give you $100 as well, too.
Oh, he succeeded. The employee didn't get angry. He was confused, but only a little bit. I'm sorry, but if there are no strong emotional reactions, what am I supposed to be laughing at? What a letdown. I should point out that during other parts of the video, Kai does other pranks. They have nothing to do with tip jars, so they're treated as secondary.
Man, I'm so happy you remember.
Damn, that bro, you know what I'm saying? You know, I'm a father too.
Yeah,
when did all this go down?
Bro, all this went down last night. I got 5 of them on the way tomorrow.
God.
Dang, about to be an uncle.
Man, I appreciate it.
Indeed, bro.
Man, I can't wait to see them, man.
Bro, they across the country, though. I'm on child support right now.
Oh, god damn.
Yeah, real shit.
All the way across the country.
Yeah.
That's some wild shit, man.
Yeah, that is, my brother.
But I hope you get past that. This was supposed to be a great situation, but now.
Nah, fuck them kids.
Okay.
I watch Ebony, a lot of Ebony adult film.
Ebony?
Ebony. What you like? What you like, man?
I don't watch porn though, but
Yeah, Ebony the best one, bro. Ebony the best one, bro. Yeah. I needed it on a high quality TV, so put me up, you know what I'm saying?
Oh my God! Kai is saying outrageous things like he means them? Why isn't that the focus of the video? Sure, it's less original than the tip jar idea, but it's more effective. If the other person is flabbergasted, the viewer laughs. If the other person isn't flabbergasted, it means that they agree with Kai's character or they're willing to enable that behavior. That's not necessarily funny, but it does provide an insight into human conduct. Okay, now I want to know what happens in the rest of the video.
Adam Sandler?
No.
Peter Parker?
Sorry.
Tobey Maguire? Justin Timberlake?
No.
Justin Bieber?
Ah, approaching strangers and pretend like you're mistaking them for celebrities. That's another good idea, but unlike the previous one, the quality of the prank relies much more on execution. Okay, let's see how it plays out.
I just want to say it's nice to meet you, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you so much. That's a nice handshake right there, my brother. What you about to get today?
I'm just looking around for some stuff.
Okay, okay. Anything you need, help with, let me know.
Okay.
I got it under the books. Indeed. Yep. Can I see you say indeed real quick? Say indeed.
Indeed.
Indeed, yep. My brother. Yes, sir. Where the bitches at, though? Like, what?
Small talk? That's it? Does this even count as a prank? It's more like a tactic to break the ice when you meet new people. Again, what am I supposed to be laughing at?
No way, bro. Mr. Beast? Mr. Oh my.
But why did you cut it at that part? How am I supposed to know if the prank failed or succeeded if you don't show it to me? People, there's a limited amount of ways you can prank someone. That's why so many pranksters do different variations of the same scenarios. Kai, I have to give you credit for at least trying something new. Also, even when things were getting heated, you stayed in character. You knew that you could get in serious trouble, but you kept going because you were committed. Not a lot of people can do that. Therefore, I think you have potential to become a good prankster. But whether that happens or not, is up to you. That's it for now. If you join my Patreon, you will get some benefits, including early access. Please subscribe to this channel and I'll see you later.